This is Innovledia.
Hello and welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to work in the component mode in Maya. Alright? So, what is component mode? Well, component mode in Maya lets you select and work with the components of an object. To switch to the component mode in Maya, you can either click on this icon on the status line, or you can right-click on the viewport and hold it down to bring up the marking menu, where you can select any of these components you want to work with. You have to right-click and hold down to bring up this menu, otherwise it will disappear if you leave your mouse button. Alright? I'm going to right-click and hold down to bring up the marking menu and select the multi-component mode for now. So what are the components of an object? In 3D, there are mainly three components of a polygonal object: the vertex, the edge, and the face. A vertex is a point or coordinate in a 3D space. It is like an XYZ coordinate. Whereas an edge is a connecting line between two vertices. And a face is a polygon or surface formed of three or more vertices or edges connected together in a loop. So in general, you can say that all points are vertices, all the lines are edges, and all the little surfaces formed in between these connecting lines are faces. Alright? Now, if we take a look on the status line with the component mode active, you get these three components to select from. This is the vertex selection mode. This is the edge selection mode. And the last one is the face selection mode. As you enable one of these modes, you will only be able to select the kind of component that you have enabled here on the status line. Like if I enable the vertex mode, I will only be able to select vertices. If I enable the edge mode, I will only be able to select edges. And if I enable the face mode, I will only be able to select faces. Alright? The same thing can be done using the marking menu. And this really helps when you are in full screen mode with no status line. If you right click and hold down within the viewport area, this marking menu will pop up, where you can switch through the various component modes. This is the vertex mode, where you can select vertices. This is the edge mode, where you can select edges. And this is the face mode, where you can select faces. There is also a multi-mode where you can select all of the components like vertices, edges, and faces. Alright? Now, one thing I would like to tell you is that before you begin modifying the components of an object, make sure you have set its dimension and subdivision values to whatever you want. Because once you start modifying the components, those options will be gone and you will not be able to change it later. However, Maya records the history of objects from beginning to end. So you can find the option to change those values later, but that will bring inappropriate results. So make sure you have set the dimension and the subdivision values before you begin working in the component mode. Alright? Okay, so let me set the subdivisions of the cube to 3 from all the sides. And then switch to the component mode, and I'm going to enable the vertex mode so that I can work with the vertices. Now, if I grab the move tool, I can select any of these vertices and move it wherever I want. I can even select a group of vertices and move them together in and out of the cube. Not only I can move them, but also rotate them using the rotate tool, and scale them as well. Alright? Now if I switch to the edge mode, I can select and move edges as well. I can also rotate them and scale them as needed. The same thing can be done with faces. If I switch to the face mode, I can select and move faces. I can rotate them. And I can scale them like we can do with rest of the components. Now one thing that you will note here is that when we move an edge, we technically move the vertices that make up the edge. Same thing goes for a face. When we move a face, we technically move the edges, or more appropriately, the vertices that make up the face. Alright? In the upcoming lessons, we'll be doing more manipulations of these components than just moving, rotating, or scaling them. That is when we'll begin with modeling. So for now, this is how we can work in the component mode in Maya. Alright? See you in the next video.